Well, let's see. How do we solve this? First, I want to identify where is the roller coaster going to be going the fastest? And the answer is when it's down here. This is the lowest point in the roller coaster, and therefore the point with the lowest potential energy, which means the highest kinetic energy. And let's see, down here, what kind of energy does it have? It has kinetic energy. I know it's got to be moving down here. And it even has a little bit of potential energy, if I'm using the ground as my reference point for zero. So let's see. Energy is conserved means energy up here equals energy down here. Roller coaster starts at rest, which means it starts with only potential energy. I'm actually going to call this H1 to distinguish it from this H over here. By the time it gets to the bottom, it still has a little bit of potential energy, and it has kinetic. We know motion doesn't depend on mass, and luckily the masses cancel out. I can do a little bit of massaging of this equation to get it into this form for V squared. Then to solve for velocity, I just take the square root. And look at that. All that matters, the only way that height comes into this equation is through the change in height, H1 minus H2. This is really pointing out the fact that we can choose our zero point anywhere, and all that matters is the change in height. Well, let's plug in our numbers. Well, when I do this, I get a very nice number. I get the square root of 900, which is exactly 30 meters per second.